Good evening, everyone. And welcome to St. Dominic's Catholic Church. This evening we celebrate the fifth Sunday of Lent. The theme is the God of Surprises. Please be reminded that there will be a second collection for the Bishop's Lenten appeal. The Lenten envelopes can be found at the entrance to the church. The intentions for this Mass offered for the souls of Eva and Sarah's son, Maria Figuera, Alexander and Ida, all souls in purgatory, Tony Eva, Jose Eva, Lourdes Eva, Horatio Cura, Adelaide Cura, Maria Cardosa, and Maria Marcellus, as well as for healing of Virginia Montes, as special intentions for Raquel de Freitas, and happy birthday blessings to Paula Veneras. The celebrant this evening is Father Graham, assisted by Andrew and Darrell. Please stand for the entrance.
Through my fault, through my misdeeds, fault. Therefore, I ask Thank you.
do not consider that I have made it to my own, but one thing I do, forgetting what lies behind and straining forward to what lies ahead, I press on towards the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. The word of the Lord.
The irony of today's gospel is that the Pharisees, in accusing the woman of sin, exposed their own sins. The turning point in this story comes when Christ bends down and writes on the ground. This is also the most intriguing part of the story. There is something mysterious about Christ writing on the ground. and it happens twice. When the Pharisees first asked about his understanding of the law of Moses, and then again when they repeated their question. The most popular interpretation of Christ writing on the ground is by Saint Jerome. He said that Christ was writing coded symbols or figures which reminded each accuser secretly of their own sins. When so confronted with their own sins, they left in shame, one by one, unequal to the challenge of Christ. Let the one who is without sin cast the first stone. This is an appealing interpretation which fits well with the story. It shows clearly how the accusations of the Pharisees backfired, exposing their own sinfulness, especially the sin of self-righteous judgment of the woman. Another interpretation holds that Christ wrote no words or symbols. He was just idly tracing on the ground. In the Semitic culture, tracing idly on the ground is a gesture of disdain. Christ was dismissing the Pharisees' question as hypocritical and expressing his disgust with their self-righteousness. By so ignoring their accusation, he indicated that something else was the real issue. The real concern was their sins, especially their heartless humiliation of the woman. Either interpretation of Christ writing on the ground carries this message. Casting stones at others reveals more about our own sinfulness than the sin of the one we accuse. This gospel story revolves around two sins: the sin of the woman, adultery, and the sin of the Pharisees, self-righteousness. But more important than their sins is their reaction to their sins. The gospel conveys a sense that the woman was repentant, while the Pharisees were not. They left, she stayed. Both were wrong, but the repentant woman was forgiven, while the unrepentant Pharisees were not. Saint Augustine said of this story, "In the end, only two remained, misery and mercy, the woman and Christ." Her misery face to face with Jesus' mercy. The gospel story is about sins, but the message is about mercy, a mercy which moves one to repentance. Too often, we remember only the clear words of Christ to the Pharisees. Let the one who is without sin cast the first stone. But Christ's humble words to the woman are even more significant. Go, but do not sin anymore. The rebuff of the Pharisees has become part of our popular language. Let the one without sin cast the first stone. the admonition to the woman, "Go, but do not sin anymore," is yet to be adopted by our culture, verbally or morally. The admonition once given to the woman guilty of the sin of adultery is now directed to every Christian who is tempted to the sin of judging others. "Go, but do not sin anymore."
Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For a spirit accepted the woman in the gospel with kindness and mercy. May we be faithful followers of Jesus, careful not to condemn others, witnessing to the compassion of our Lord. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious and hear us.
For the grace to avoid hypocrisy, the rulers of the people showed hypocrisy when confronted by Jesus. May we be people of the truth, witnessing to the gospel by lives of integrity. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious and hear us.
I pray for those who are sick in our parish, especially Ursula Hurley, Simon Rogero, Wanda Talbot, Amanda Hill, Jennifer Zell, Lynn Saunders, Dawn Rossini, Sebastian Buchanan, Paula Furry, Dawn Otero, Wendy Schultz, Geraldine Jones, David Bowes, Jill Nettle, Nelson Moons, Katja Gobert. They may experience the consolation of the power of Christ. Lord, hear us.
Lord, gracious, hear us.
God of compassion and love, teach us your ways. Hear the prayers we make through Jesus Christ.
Thank you. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, almighty and eternal God, through Christ our Lord, for by your gracious gift each year, your faithful await the sacred Paschal feast with joy of my Savior. So that for you, intent on prayer, and by the words of charity, and participating in the mysteries, I wish every the blood of the new and into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, and Witte our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who died for your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, the Blessed Joseph of Christ, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Dominic, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may guarantee progress to eternal life, and have praise and glory on you, through your Son, Jesus Christ. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
We Lent migrants will be on call on Tuesday before last during Lent at 7 p.m. here in the church. This coming week, the fifth topic will be leadership in our church. The Dispatches of the Cross on Wednesday at 7 p.m. And then RCIA for 2022, the new program for RCIA starts on the 23rd of April 2022. This is a course for candidates 18 years and older to receive the sacraments of baptism, first holy communion, and confirmation. Kindly contact Moses Tartus for more details. His details are available. Catholic Women's League, the next OBR meeting will be on Saturday the 18th of June in St. Clair's Hall at 2 p.m. St. Vincent de Paul and Catholic Women's League would like to thank the parishioners for their support. The jumble sale that took place on the 26th of March. This event raised a generous amount of 4,370 rand. Also, the SVPP would like to give a sincere thank you for the enormous list of donations received. St. Dominic's Parish Catechism. Please take note that the Catechism lessons for Term 2 resume with palm making in the hall on the 9th of April from 8 a.m. to 11 a.m. All are most welcome. The Knights of the Garden. The Knights are serving bacon and Prager rolls at CBC on Palm Sunday after the 10 a.m. Mass on the 10th of April. Please do come along and support it.
The Lord be with you. Bless, O Lord, the people who long for the gift of your mercy, and grant us what is your prompting they desire, they may receive by your generous gift through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And now, might God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorify the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Saint Michael, the Archangel, defend us in the hour of battle. Be our protection against